Hillcrest Baptist Church. So let us stand as we join together and sing, "He has made me glad." Welcome us into your presence as we praise and glorify your name. All the glory, honor, thanksgiving, and power be unto you forever and ever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Just look to your left there. There's our open hymn. Come share the Lord.
Do not be angry because of the wicked. Do not be envious of wrongdoers.
For they will soon fade like the grass and wither like the green herb.
Trust in the Lord and do good, so you will dwell in the land and enjoy security.
Take delight in the Lord, who will give you the desires of your heart.
Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in God, who will act, bringing forth your vindication as the light and your right as the noonday.
Be still and wait patiently before the Lord. Do not be angry because of those who prosper in their way, because of those who carry out evil devices.
Refrain from anger and forsake wrath. Do not be angry, it leads only to evil.
The wicked shall be cut off, but those who wait for the Lord shall possess the land.
Yet a little while, and the wicked will be no more. Though you look at their place, they will not be there.
But the meek shall possess the land and delight in abundant prosperity.
As it was in heaven. seated. As we prepare our hearts, as we come before God's holy table, I invite you to turn to page 12 in your hymnal. Page 12 in your hymnal. And join me in the invitation and the pardon. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another.
Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors. We have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray,
and free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Beloved, hear the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that God loves us. God loves us so much that he sent Jesus into the world to die for the forgiveness of our sins. And so, in that mighty act, we are able to say, in the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. We invite our ushers to come forward as we worship God with God's tithes and our offerings. Holy Lord, in this act of worship, we ask that you bless the gifts and the givers to further your kingdom here on earth and us in your service. In Christ's holy name, amen.
Thank you. me in this historic confession of the Christian faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. We're going to invite our president and members of our neck of the woods 4-H if they'll come up front as we make a presentation. A couple weeks ago, the local chapter, our neck of the woods 4-H club, had a very special bingo tournament. I don't know how many of y'all participated in the bingo. It was a lot of fun, but I want to say that was the worst bingo caller I have ever seen in my entire life. I did not win once. So, anyhow, maybe if we just get a little better bingo caller next time, that's one thing. And I didn't have my nemesis there this year, so I had to have somebody to challenge me on. But they did that in service, and they wanted to donate their proceeds to Marvin's ministry, Love in a Bag. And on top of that, they got together last Wednesday and they packed Love in a Bag. And if you've ever been a part of that ministry, you know what a big deal that is. So they helped pack it, which is a ministry that Marvin takes into the school systems and helps to support young people that may or may not get a good meal in some situations. And so we have a presentation of the funds for that. Not only that, they put together this neat hands and symbol of service that they wanted to present to us, and so we received this in the name of the church, and we celebrate that. And so how much money did the 4-H Club raise for Love in a Bag? Say it loud.
$1,500.
I didn't have anybody with cameras, but yeah, we appreciate this. We thank you and receive this in the name of the Lord. Thank you. Just set that down to your desk. Give thanks for Will and his service to the church. This is the first time that he leads us in our worship. We appreciate it. He's doing a good job. We appreciate Will. Maybe you get up here and do it one time and see what that's like. What else are we celebrating? Sunshine. It's a pretty day. It's not raining like it was last Thursday. Woo, I thought I was going to have to build an ark. I give thanks for a lot of things, but don't forget, sometimes you have to do without before you begin to be grateful for it. The furnace went out in the parsonage, and so we've been without heat, but I'm grateful. One, I married a Yankee. She likes it cold. And so I'm grateful also we have a fireplace and we have trustees that are on the spot and able to make things work and able to help out. We're going to have to replace the furnace, so this is a little bit of a cue. If you're sitting on some extra money and you want to make a donation to replace the parsonage furnace, we need it. So anybody listening from on YouTube or Facebook, if you can make a donation toward the furnace, we appreciate it. So enough of that. What else are we celebrating? A full house today. Good to see everybody. Well, we had a row of children back there. I think there was just too hot to handle. But if we hear some screaming in the back, we know where it's coming from. It's happening. Yes, ma'am.
David's brother nephew loves
Marvin. As we gather in peace and as we celebrate. have plenty of folks that we miss that aren't able to be here. We have plenty at home. Don't forget Roger and Linda Polk and the Rosses and, come on, the Gordons. All these people are that used to be here and tell me what to do, and they're not here, so I'm lost. We just appreciate the roots and the foundation, the history of this church, and if you get a chance, reach out to them. As we pray, Jeff Main is with his uncle, Mike Homer, who's having open heart surgery, and asks for prayers. We celebrate Keller Patterson, who is away at confirmation camp as we speak. He should be coming home shortly. So Keller is our only confirmand this year, but he's brave enough to go off to camp by himself. We keep him in our prayers as we continue confirmation training and look forward to him joining the church, maybe with some others, come Palm Sunday. Also, Julie, we haven't forgotten about you. Julie continues to take care of her mother who's on hospice care, so she's with us this morning. Who else are we praying for? Yes, ma'am.
My aunt, Linda Ross, not related to any of these Rosses, but she broke her neck last night. She's going to have surgery either tonight or this morning.
Okay, Desi's Aunt Linda who broke her hip. Anybody else? As we sit in peace and comfort, we're mindful that we have soldiers across this world that are in harm's way. We have first responders that are ready to be there for us. We have people that are watching over us. And don't forget to give thanks for being able to sit here in peace. And so as we unite our hearts, the Lord be with you. Still plenty around this world that literally confess Jesus as their Lord because it's illegal to be a Christian where they are. So Lord, let us live into the power of your presence. We lift up those that we've mentioned. We know that you already know those that we lift up in our hearts. Help us so to live and to serve in the blessings of who you have raised us to do and to be, so that Lord, your light might shine in this world. We give you thanks in Christ's holy name. Amen.
Thank you.
Because in the year 2023, most of us will just walk into a room, flip a switch, and the light is there. Light is cheap. Light is easy. Most of us will stay up until 10, 11, midnight because we have the lights in the house. Now, there's some folks here old enough, I'm not going to say who, but they remember when they might not have had lights in the house. And when the sun went down, you did what? You went to bed. Because there wasn't anything else you pretty much could do. Now, you could burn candles, or if you had an oil lamp, you could burn that, but that costs money. Back in my grandmother's day, she wasn't about to spend any money, but she could go to bed. That's the way it was in the first century. Now, many people did have these little lamps, these little oil lamps with a wick that would stick out of it, and that oil was expensive. Not everybody had them. But if they were to do something at night, they had to light that lamp, and you didn't put it down low, and you didn't cover it up. That defeated the purpose of it. You put it up high where it would illuminate the entire room. Jesus in this metaphor says, you are the light of the world. You're not to be held back, held down in your faith. But you're supposed to be lifted up because you're that special. You're that unique. Every single one of you has a story to tell about Christ in your heart and Christ in your life. And that in that way, we let our light shine before others so that they would know Christ in our hearts. I think the point of this is that you're special. You're special and you're necessary. And we don't need to overlook the cheapness of what salt means to us today or light means today because it's easy. This is a hard thing. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit of Christ is a tough thing for Christians to carry in this world today. There's a lot of meanness out there. There's a lot of hardness out there. There's a lot of folks that want to just be angry and talk bad about everything and want to bring darkness and more into this world. And as Christians, as people of faith, we need to share that faith and say, you know what? It's not as bad as you think because God's got this. And it's not about pointing fingers at other people and placing blame on other people. It's about how do we live day to day. Sharing our faith and sharing our love in Jesus Christ. Because that's how we're like salt and we see to this world. That's how we're like light and we shine our light out even into the darkest of places. May God grant us grace that we may have the strength and the power to know that we're special. This is how special you are. Because God needed to know that you can have a resource to come back to be salty. To come back to being brilliant. And to come back to the faith time and time again. That's why Jesus said, whenever you get together, do this in remembrance of me. And so Christ came in human form. And he sat with those first disciples. And he broke the bread and he said, this is my body. It's kind of like the saltiness that we spread around. This is my blood. It's kind of like the light that we shine. Whenever you participate in this, you share in the fullness and the faithfulness of the church because you are special and the world needs to know this. I invite you to join me on page 13 of our hymnal as we come once again to God's Holy Hymn.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water on the Holy Spirit. On the night which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread. He gave thanks to you. He broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." And so, Lord, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ, offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is God, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, one in ministry and to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and with the Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now let us pray with the confidence of the children of God, the prayer our Lord taught us when he said, "Say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen."
Beloved, it's the body of Christ, broken for you. It's the blood of Christ shed for you. We're going to invite our servants if they come down first. One day the church is going to figure out how to do the new modern rituals of washing hands and wearing gloves. But we do this for your protection. As you come, I want you to know, want everybody to know that this is an open table. It's for Christians of all faiths and faiths of all Christians. As you come under the direction of the ushers, we invite you to go all the way to the end. So we got a lot of people here, and we want to serve as many as we can in one shot. Any monies that might be left at the altar will go to our Love in the Bag ministry. As that continues.
So we're going to invite the choir to come first.
Rise now with the peace of God. God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you from now on and evermore.
Thank you.
free and know that God has made you special. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Let all God's children say,
Amen. Amen.